One of the main issues for candidates in this midterm election is immigration, particularly finding ways to address migrants illegally crossing the U.S.-Mexico border. In this special report from our correspondent Len Almadin Thornhill, we'll meet some Kababayans from the Rio Grande Valley in Texas who've been doing their part to help, not just those who recently crossed the border, but also some anxious members of their communities.
Even before these images surfaced, or these cries were heard, Filipinos living along the Rio Grande River in Texas have been doing what they could to help migrant families. Dr. Alan Mercado is one of the doctors who has volunteered at the respite center in McAllen. Sister Norma Pimentel manages the center that temporarily takes in asylum seekers.
So what Sister Norma usually does, they bring him to the church, they give him a bath, they feed him, they choose clothes from each pile right there. And before they go to the bus, I see them. Because some of them would have headaches, some of them would have diarrhea. So I would see most of them.
At the height of the implementation of the zero tolerance policy from May to August, Filipinos in the valley not only volunteered at churches and shelters, but they got together on their days off to cook and serve at the center.
Ganun kami rito mga Pilipino. Tsaka masarap kasi magtulong eh. Sa totoo lang. Masarap magtulong kaysa ikaw tutulungan.
Even though Cherry Somosot is not fluent in Spanish, she has been volunteering at Proyecto Desarrollo Humano for many years. The organization helps mostly newly arrived Hispanic immigrants living in Panitas who live below the poverty line.
It takes me like 45 minutes to travel to the Proyecto, but once I'm there, all those, you know, all those, like, you're tired, it goes away once you see them, because you can feel their sincerity and their love for learning, yes. And parents are just so nice.
Sometimes they said the children just wanted to hear reassurance.
Oh, I can't go there because my parents didn't have papers. They won't gonna, you know, check your papers there. You're just gonna go and, you know, park your car and watch a show. And there's no border control there.
They all say they have their own struggles as immigrants, but the valley has given them not only the opportunities to have better lives, but a unique responsibility to help new migrants realize their American dream. Len Amadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News, McAllen, Texas.